Hello everyone, and welcome. Today we'll be doing a mini-review for our newest legendary hero, Legendary Lyn. Whether you like her or not, she's here to stay, so we may as well talk about her. Before we talk about Lyn specifically, let's take a minute and talk about the introduction of colored archers in general. Although having a colored does hurt in some matchups, I think it is better than being colorless. Weapons like Brave or Fire Sweep Bow are already strong, and adding extra damage on top of them with scaling is a great thing. Archers use a shared weapon pool. Any archer, red, blue, green, or colorless, can inherit the same weapons. This makes building archers easy. We don't need to wait for a green Fire Sweep Bow because Lyn can just inherit the normal one. Bowbreaker also doesn't work on colored archers. The tooltip specifically says colorless only. Overall, colored archers should be evaluated more like physical units of their color, not like other archers. Mixing them into the weapon triangle changes them in a fundamental way, and it's important not to forget that. Okay, back to Lyn. Lyn is a green archer with 151 BST. She is a legendary hero with the Wind Affinity. Lyn's stats are about what you'd expect. Her speed is excellent, her attack is okay, and her bulk isn't actually that bad given her speed. Her defense is her main weakness. Lyn only has a combined 57 physical bulk. Lyn's personal weapon is the Swift Mulligear. Swift Mulligear is a 14 might bow with +3 res. Like all bows, it deals effective damage versus flying units. Additionally, in combat, if there are more allies within two spaces of Lyn than enemies, not including Lyn or her opponent, Lyn gains 5 attack and speed. Swift Mulligear is really good. If you can activate the effect, which I think most players can, Swift Mulligear effectively has 19 damage, 5 speed, and 3 res. It's hard to argue with those kinds of bonuses. This is just speculation, but I feel like Brave Lyn will get access to this weapon in a month or two, and it's going to be great on her as well. Lyn's assist is Rally Defense Res, her B skill is Desperation, and her C skill is Speed Tactic. Speed Tactic is a welcome addition, but it is sad that it's going to be legendary locked. Lyn's personal A skill is Laws of Sakai. If an enemy attacks Lyn, she makes a check. If there are two or more allies within two spaces, she gains 4 to her attack, speed, defense, and res. This skill is powerful, but it has a few quirks that we should go over. First, unlike Swift Mulligear or Flame Siegmund, the number of enemies doesn't matter. The only thing that Laws of Sakai checks is the number of nearby allies. Second, unlike Owl Tomes or other similar skills, Laws of Sakai only works on the enemy phase. You can't use these bonus stats while attacking. Third, Laws of Sakai uses a greater than or equal to instead of a greater than. That might be an error, but it might not. If it isn't, then Lyn can sometimes find herself in situations where Laws of Sakai activates, but Swift Mulligear doesn't, and she'll miss out on those stats. Fourth, although this one is obvious, because Laws of Sakai is an A skill, Lyn can't combine it with Close Counter, at least not until we get a Close Counter seal. All that being said, I'm genuinely unimpressed by Laws of Sakai. It's cool, but the fact that it competes with Close Counter means that it's a skill without a home. As is, Laws of Sakai only helps Lyn duel other archers or mages on the enemy phase, and if that's all you need your enemy phase green unit to do, you have plenty of other choices that are both more common and more effective. At a glance, Lyn is a unit pulled in two directions. She has a stat line that is very similar to player phase archers like Setsuna or Summer Gaius. However, her personal A skill and the Swift Mulligear will be much easier to use on the enemy phase. I think the intent behind Legendary Lyn was to create a mixed phase archer. She would tank on one turn, get into desperation range, and then go on the attack. I'm not sure how I feel about that, but it is something different. Regardless, I would recommend that players build Legendary Lyn as a player phase archer. Weapons like Brave Bow or Fire Sweep are time tested, and if it ain't broke, don't fix it. If you'd rather keep her personal weapon, that's fine too, just make sure that you run enough defense to avoid dying to distant counter. Your choice of IV isn't too important. As long as you get a plus attack or a plus speed nature, you're fine. In the A slot, Lyn will gravitate towards staple player phase skills like Swift Sparrow, Death Blow, or Life and Death. Fury is also an option since it works on both phases and synergizes with Desperation. The B skill, likewise, will feature old standbys like Desperation and Vantage, but high investment players may want to consider premium skills like Chill Defense or Speed. Finally, the Special, C slot, and Seal will be flexible. Specials depend on choice of weapon, C skills depend on teammates, and Seals depend on everything else. it's difficult to prescribe builds for Lyn that aren't just rehashes of existing sets. If you want to get creative and use Laws of Sakai, I'd really recommend that you just keep her base kit. Let her bait on turn 1 or 2, and then go aggressive from there. Like I said earlier, I'm not sure it's going to work, but it is worth a shot. Lyn, like most legendary heroes, is kind of an underwhelming unit. In battle, she won't be too much stronger than someone like Setsuna, and she certainly won't be as powerful as her mounted version. If you're expecting the second coming of Brave Lyn, then I have bad news. But if you just want a unit with great art, cool animations, and a little bit of utility on the side, then Legendary Lyn might be the unit for you. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like or subscribing. You can find me on Twitter at DireThunderYT, so feel free to send me cool stuff or just drop by to say hello. As always, I hope to see you next time. Take care.